Susan Marr, at 21, this year's youngest candidate. Bright.
Try and find 3 locations we can get those things from, heading east.
Enthusiastic.
I think I speak for all of us when I say that we love it.
And self-assured.
I have natural entrepreneurial spirit, so much drive and so many ideas, and I'm confident that my business with Lord Sugar will make millions.
She won with the girls for the first 2 weeks. But having 7 older teammates often meant she struggled to get heard.
Okay, I just thought of this. I think it's a brilliant idea. Okay, so imagine if you've got 2 people standing next to each other and you've got, okay, how do I say this? Okay, so you're you and I'm me and I say, okay, so if I ask you a question like, where do you think we are? But
Susie,
the text that comes up,
Susie,
is that,
I'm gonna stop
can you
now
please just let me finish?
Susie, no.
So in week 3, the negotiation task.
I do a lot of buying in my line of business, so I will be putting myself forward as project manager.
Susan took control.
Fillet steak is done.
Yep.
Organza is done.
Yeah.
Top hat is done.
Yeah.
Felicity, you come with us. We're going to do the hat shop.
Okay,
so you guys go right now. Make sure you've got all the information. Go now. Go now.
I think she started very well, and I think she's quite a little force to be reckoned with.
Her leadership clinched victory, 3rd in a row.
It's a win. It's a win.
Susie is incredible. I think she's 10 years younger than me and has had a huge amount of experience of selling things, of developing things, and I'm quite amazed with her abilities for her age.
The only child of a single parent, Susan had to grow up quickly. Born in China, as a toddler, she lived in Shanghai.
We had no electricity, no gas, no heating at all, and it was absolutely freezing all the time. I remember I had like a little bucket that my mum used to bathe me in the sort of the back shed, and we had a little hole in the ground where we would go to the toilet, and everything was so simple and so poor.
Age 7, she moved with her mum to Australia.
I was always bullied pretty much every day just for the fact that I couldn't speak any English. I felt really, really left out because I didn't understand the culture. I didn't understand anything that we were learning at school, and it was a really, really tough time for me.
After 5 years, they were off again, this time to Britain.
When I moved to England, unfortunately, my mum couldn't speak a word of English.
She only 12, how can she help me? Then I realised she can speak a very good English.
I had to help my mum with regards to getting bank loans, look through newspapers, trying to find places to live, and also I had to enrol myself in my own school. It was a really big struggle. I don't know how we got through, but we did it in the end.
Susan juggled schoolwork with helping on her mum's market stall.
I've been working in markets since I was 13, ever since I came to England, and it's what I'm part of.
Susie's mum worked at Greenwich Market every day, carrying stock on the public transport. And there's definitely sort of this bond between them that you can tell that these two have been through a lot together.
£12.
I think in watching her mum go through all that as she grew up, she took more responsibility on herself and wanted to support her and give her as comfortable a life as possible. I mean, everything she does for her mum.
3 years ago, Susan set up her skincare business. Making money at markets, online, and at trade shows, she soon paid off her mum's mortgage.
She makes the money, she gave me all. She didn't leave her money, even one penny.
My mum is the most important person in my life.
And she's so clever. When she did the business, I'm really very, very proud of her.
Seeing what products are going to sell and interacting directly with the customers is exactly what I'm used to.
Morning.
Week 4, the beauty task. It looked like a smooth run for Susan.
I have to say, I've actually been selling skincare products for the last 3 years, so this is right up my street. I just want to let you know that I'm more than confident that we will sell out of all of these products.
Yeah, I'll roll with that then.
But pretty soon, cracks started to show.
Is it a little bit too expensive for you, or is that the problem?
I'm not selling anywhere near as much as I thought I'd be selling.
You thought 6 an hour, didn't you?
Oh, no one has any money around here. Everyone seems so poor.
Having put herself up as a beauty guru who understood the market, she completely let herself down. She didn't deliver, she didn't follow through, she hadn't thought about the process, and actually it was at that point she lost an awful lot of credibility with the other candidates.
Susie, you came up with these optimistic numbers. You're in skincare anyway.
This is so unfair, Zoe.
No, it's not unfair, Susie. You've made your bed and you've got to lie in it, I'm afraid. Try and recall it back and try and get the sales.
Yeah. I don't understand why you come here and just have a go at me.
After that, her judgment was in question. On the rubbish task, no one took her views seriously.
I don't know what's in your head at the minute, Susie.
It's whoever offers the higher amount for all these goods to the guy that will get it.
We're not giving him 100 quid.
Maybe I've gotten the complete wrong end of the stick then.
But after losing both big clearance contracts, Susan was proved right.
I won't be using your services tomorrow. The resale value of the furniture was quite high, so I thought that I would get something for the furniture.
OK, no problem. Bye.
Bye now.
So you were right, Susie.
So he did want money for the furniture. So I'm not an idiot.
There is a failure somewhere, isn't it? And that is that you cave in too fast to weightier voices. Because I think sometimes you talk great sense, but you don't push your point strongly enough because you're overawed by those around you.
Susan, I'm giving you another chance, OK?
Week 7. With the free magazine task, it didn't get any better.
All agreed on hip replacement, say aye.
Aye.
Okay. Is that an aye, Susie?
No, but I'm happy to support it. No problem at all.
When hip replacement bombed, it was fight back or get fired.
I think I was the only person who disagreed with the name.
But you didn't make yourself strong.
I didn't hear anything.
Your voice must have been lost in translation.
I absolutely didn't hear it.
Did you hear it? You were in her company.
She did say she wasn't agreed with it, but there was no real strength behind it.
It's a whisper in the night.
That was incredibly tough for me because I felt that Jim and Glenn had both sort of stuck together to gang up on me, feeling that I was probably the weakest out of the three.
Who's responsible for the failure of this task is the meek little mouse, and that's Susan.
Jim and Glenn, they tried to have a go at her. They tried to destroy her. They tried to stamp all over her.
I feel that throughout this entire process, every single thing that I have done has been overlooked.
Out she came. Out she came fighting, saw them off.
I honestly feel that they look at me and they think, young, naive, no experience, let's pick on her, let's get rid of her.
Fearless little thing, great guts, and I admire her for that.
I am 21 and I have had...
Stop using your age, it doesn't make any difference.
I'm saying,
when you guys were
21, you didn't have the initiative to do anything that I have done so far.
Fair comment, the mouse that roared.
Because of what I've been through in my life, I'm a very tough person. I have learned to make sure that my voice is heard. I learn from the mistakes, I learn from what has happened, and I move on.
Paris.
Ah.
Fired up and project manager, Susan stormed back.
I'm trying to find products that are going to be sellable to the mass market because I want volume. It was perfect for me. I was very good at spotting the two products that would sell the most.
Bonjour.
What you're missing, I think, is a fantastic universal grip and got a lot of money from it. You can fit your phone in like this. And when you're driving, you can change the next song. Well, how many pieces are you after?
1,000.
Can I tempt you with any more than that? Because we have another price bracket to go down.
Okay,
we'll do that. Mm? So 1,500 pieces at €7.50.
Okay.
She's dealt in foreign markets, and that experience came to the fore. She also understood volume, and she picked the right products, and she led that team to a great victory.
I've got euro signs in my eyeballs now. I've won more money!
Susan started in business as a teenager, and now at 21, she's sort of seasoned, experienced businesswoman. And that fact alone will be hugely attractive to Lord Sugar. She can only now build on what she's already learned. But you know, there are a few problems too. She has an unhappy knack of rubbing people up the wrong way, strangely.
You don't shut up.
Okay.
You keep going. It's like a school kid going, can I do this, can I do this, can I do this? On and on and on and on and on.
And secondly, she's really got to learn to forcibly push her arguments forward if she's to be a partner with Lord Sugar.